The clerk will designate the amendment.
Amendment number 334, printed in Part B of House Report Number 116-461, offered by Mr. Posey of Florida.
Pursuant to House Resolution 1067, the gentleman from Florida, Mr. Posey, and a member opposed, each will control 5 minutes. The chair recognizes the gentleman from Florida.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Residents and local businesses along the way have expressed concerns about the upcoming high-speed rail project being built along Florida's East Coast and through my district. A high number of fatalities have already been associated with the train since the South Florida operations began in 2018. In fact, over the past 3 years, 75 deaths have been recorded along the rail corridor, with more than 40 deaths involving the new high-speed train. Last year, the Associated Press analyzed data from the Federal Railroad Administration and concluded that the project had the worst per-mile death rate of all the nation's 821 railroads. These trains will travel at fast speeds through existing town centers and residential areas in my district, with little separating the tracks from the surrounding communities. I've had concern for local schools in my district. There are several that are positioned very close or adjacent to the tracks. Gifford Middle School and North County Elementary School in Vero Beach, and the Ascension Catholic School in Melbourne, just to name a couple of them. Many students walking to and from school must cross these tracks, and we all have an interest in their safety. I would like to thank my good friend and colleague, Congressman Brian Mass, for working together with me on this amendment and for standing up for the safety of our constituents. Our amendment simply asks the Federal Railroad Administration and the Federal Highway Administration to conduct a pedestrian, motorist, and student safety study along the corridor and to report back their recommendations to increase safety. The amendment simply increases the FRA's rail safety operations budget by $2 million from the program's reserve funds. My office reached out to both the FRA and the FHWA for technical assistance on doing such a study, and neither agency expressed any objection whatsoever. In fact, FRA expressed support for it. Staff from both the minority and the majority offices assisted in drafting this amendment, and I sincerely want to thank them for working together and stepping up to help on this. The rail corridor is a recipient of federal money and has been authorized for private activity bonds, so the federal government has been involved in the funding and financing of this project. Since federal resources are being expended, it only makes sense that we should make sure it's safe for the surrounding communities. The introduction of high-speed rail for our Florida communities will undoubtedly present safety challenges that need to be properly addressed, and that's the purpose of this amendment. I ask my colleagues to join us in looking out for the safety of our residents, motorists, and school children, and support our amendment.
Pursuant to House Resolution 1067, the previous question is ordered on the amendment offered by the gentleman from Florida. The question on the amendment, those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed say no. In the opinion of the chair, the ayes have it. The amendment is agreed to. Without objection, the motion to reconsider is laid upon the table.